So, you know, the governor came in 2002 talking about getting a lot of work done.
Right.
And we aren't there yet.
Did he call us the East State or something?
He did. You remember, at one point, he gave his state of the state address and he held up his cell phone. He says, we're going to have this cell phone coverage every place in the state. And I got to tell you, Governor, it's not happening.
Uh-huh.
I've got mine, and I was in the town of Shelburne, the village of Shelburne. I don't have cell phone access in the village of Shelburne or with my company in the Mad River Valley. You know, there are places that between my home in Richmond and Burlington.
Gaps everywhere.
Yeah, it's like, I think we all know that.
Yeah.
So we've got a long ways to go, but it's still really important. So the future of Fairpoint, I don't know. They've gone through a major restructuring. Somebody's going to have to be out there to provide the service to Vermont, but we haven't been well served.
Agreed.
Yes.
The Public Service Board also oversees, makes decisions about Vermont Yankee.
Yes.
In interaction with the legislature, though, I mean, how does the relicensing happens in the legislature, but the board does oversight or?
The legislature has to approve a license extension. That's the way that was set up.
Okay.
In fact, Governor Douglas agreed with that a few years ago. He doesn't agree with it anymore. He thinks we ought to butt out.
They wanted to use this. They thought this would be a good year to bring that issue up.
They thought so. Yeah. This has turned out to not be a good year.
Right.
I've said this for quite some time now. For a variety of reasons, I don't think Vermont Yankee should continue past 2012. And right now I'm having some doubts whether they should continue past today. Because every day we're hearing worse and worse news. And the news today, as we're filming this, is that Vermont Yankee's acknowledging that there's probably radioactive water in the Connecticut River. Every day it's getting worse.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that Vermont.
And that's what they're telling us.
And that's what we know, and they don't have a good track record of being upfront.
Transparency,
Yeah, absolutely. So those concerns have been out there for a while, though. Remember the pictures from a while back of the cooling tower collapse.
Mm-hmm.
And that was sort of a vivid reminder that this is an old plant.
Yeah.
And there are a lot of concerns about the plant. So I think, the way I put it is, Vermont's future energy use does not include nuclear power. And I'm ready to move into the future.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to wait 20 more years to say, let's make a commitment to conservation and efficiency and renewable energy and hydropower and all the things that we could do.
Right.
Let's get that process rolling now.
What's nice about Vermont and our tendency to give governors a long tenure, 8 or 10 years, the last two, is that you could be wrapping up your fifth term in 2020. Where would you like to? What's our energy mix in 2020?
It'd be good to paint a nicer picture. I would have us try to really start by reducing our demand. I've watched it happen. The city of Burlington's been very aggressive with conservation and efficiency measures, and they actually invest their money into helping people be more efficient. And that's a good model. And there are other communities around the country that have done that. So I'd like to see us really bring that demand line down.
Mm-hmm.
So that's to me, is a good place to start. We're going to need base load power. And I believe a lot of that is going to come from hydro. Hydro-Quebec, I believe, will continue to be a major part of our mix. I think the governor missed a great opportunity a few years ago with the dams on the Connecticut mm-hmm. River, which was very inexpensive power, which we could have owned.
They were up for sale.
They were up for sale, and we had the opportunity to buy them at a fire sale rate, and the power costs are really inexpensive mm-hmm. and predictable. They don't go up and down depending on the price of oil. So that was a lost opportunity. But
a private concern picked that up, knowing how good an investment it was. Huh?
We could have done it. That's right.
Yeah.
So I think there's going to be hydropower as a part of our base. I believe natural gas is probably going to be part of the mix in 2020. It has a carbon impact, and I would love to reduce our dependence on that. But in the short term, I believe that's going to be the reality of the situation.
Right.
We expect natural gas prices to stay fairly low. But we need to be increasing our investments and encouraging Vermont utilities and individual Vermonters to be increasing their investments in renewables. Wind has great potential. Solar has maybe it's somewhat limited potential in Vermont, particularly in January and February. We haven't seen the sun much
right.
since the first of the year. But there's still some of that potential biomass, and mm-hmm. there are limits on that. We don't want to clear cut our forests.
Sure.
But there's still, we can do more in biomass than we have been doing. There's renewable energy and wind power in other places. Northern New York State has a lot of wind power. Mm-hmm. They just have a hard time getting it out. And so I've been talking to some folks about, you know, maybe we need to be working with New York State to bring some of that power into Vermont. There are costs to that too. I mean, these things all have costs. You're going to have transmission lines if that's going to happen. But that's I see a much healthier mix. But it starts to me, with me, it starts with efficiency and conservation. We can do a whole lot more than we're doing.
So we're not on the hook with Vermont Yankee. We have a wide range of options that
I believe
don't
we do.
Force our hand to sign up for another round with them.
I believe we do. And, first of all, Entergy came back with a price which was, you know, much more expensive than we're paying today, and it was for half as much power. And I do know that our utilities have been planning for a future without Vermont Yankee. They both supported continuing it, but they recognize that they have to plan uh-huh. for that contingency. Uh-huh. They have to plan for an unplanned outage at Vermont Yankee too, if the plant goes down. And what they will tell you is that they would be able to sign some contracts for natural gas generated power that's going on elsewhere in New England and the Northeast. So I believe that we can get through this. The lights aren't going to go out. And again, I believe most Vermonters are ready to move forward.
Great. we just have a couple minutes, and I want to broach a very controversial topic. People in the blogosphere tend to be, you know, a little bit of geeks.
Okay. So, not a word I would use.
Yeah. So the really, you know, a central question that can be a window to the soul is Star Trek or Star Wars? Where do you stand?
Well, I guess I'm more of a Star Trek fan than Star Wars. But I love Star Wars too, particularly the first three episodes that were out that are confusingly episodes 4, 5, and 6.
Right.
But I really enjoyed those. But I gotta tell you, I was a space junkie back in the 1960s. I thought I was going to grow up to be an aerospace engineer. I didn't think I'd ever fly. It didn't seem like something I wanted to do. But maybe I was a geek in my time. Uh-huh. I really enjoyed science fiction. So Star Trek, I got hooked on. And then Star Trek, The Next Generation, I really enjoyed. I thought the great plots, great stories, mm-hmm. Great episodes. Star Wars was a lot of fun. But I can go back and watch Star Trek over and over and over again. Star Wars, I don't think I can watch that as often as I do Star Trek.
All right. There you have it, viewers. you be the judge. Doug, thanks a lot. This was fun.
This was really fun. I really enjoyed
this conversation. We covered a lot of ground, and we got in a lot of substance. So best of luck.
Thanks. Thanks very much.
It's really great to see how all the candidates are addressing the issues.
Great. Well, thanks. And I hope people will visit the website. And they made it easy for me to understand. It's just simply DougRacine.com. If I can remember it, you can remember it too.
Great. Good night, people.
Good night.
Bye.
Knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked. Most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.